MMA India Show.
So guys, this is Sohail from MMAIndia.com and I'm here with Mohammad Farhad, who is having his fight tomorrow at Brave 30. So we're going to have a small chat with him. Hi Farhad.
Hello.
Welcome to MMA India.
Thank you so much for having me.
So here we are just one day before the fight.
Yeah.
How are you feeling today and how do you feel about your Saturday night fight?
The main thing was the weight cut, which I didn't do to lose much weight this time, fighting in the catch weight division. So I think I'm feeling already good, already strong. I enjoyed my food this time. I could, all the time I had to skip my tasty meals and go with the, vegetables and all these things to avoid sweets. So I'm feeling strong, good. I think I'm ready for tomorrow's fight.
Sounds great. And your original opponent was Rudra Pratap Singh.
Yeah.
But due to some contractual things, he had to pull out.
Mm-hmm.
So, you had a last minute replacement. So how are you feeling mentally, considering that, you had to spend the entire camp fighting for one opponent and mm-hmm. at the last moment someone steps up, but that too also on a very short notice.
Exactly. Actually, no fighters like this to have a replacement in the last moment. That's a true thing. I was not ready to fight Rana Rudra in the first thing, but then Brave told me to take a night to think, and it came out positive with my masters and all. So I thought, let's do this, let's give an Indian an opportunity to fight in a big platform with me. It's fine if I support any Indian fighter and all, to give them some promotion. But at the end I got disappointed because Rana tried to cheat on contract, but he's of nowhere now. So Brave threw him out, and even one championship threw him out.
Okay.
So he cannot fight in one championship also. Maybe he'll get chance next time, but they are not happy with this step of his. Kushal, on the other hand, I know this guy. He's a good guy. Kushal is a good guy. So I thought, instead of letting this fight go, there was no other option than him. Nobody was ready to step in. So I thought, let's do this then. So I gave it a shot.
And I believe the last fight also, you had a last minute replacement and you won that fight at Brave.
Yeah, it was. So, it was the same thing, correct.
So
I've been to this once.
Yeah. So you think this will be play an advantage for you somehow, that you're gonna, because it's getting used to it, so you're so this might be in your favor.
I wouldn't say an advantage, right? I have to stick to my game plan. So same thing. I think Rana was a grappler and Kushal is a striker and plus a purple belt in BJJ, so I think he will try to take me down and do something on the ground. So I think my plan will be the same for both of these fighters, so I'm pretty much okay with that now.
And considering you haven't fought in the last 1 year,
mm-hmm.
but on the other hand, Kushal has fought four times in 2019.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think this would be any kind of advantage for him, and how do you want to tackle this puzzle called Kushal Vyas?
Yeah, it can be an advantage for him because he's been regular in fitness and training and fights and all, which greases your body
mm-hmm.
a lot to open up your skills, to build up your skills. I think he has an advantage in that point, but in the experience point of view, in fighting in big promotions, I think I have more experience than him. So I think I have that the biggest advantage than him in this point, if I say.
Correct. And since he is also an Indian, mm-hmm. how do you feel like fighting another Indian on a very big platform?
Mm-hmm.
Or what are your thoughts on this?
There's no point fighting an Indian, actually. I think I should move on to the international fighters and all, and I requested Brave to do so. But this time Brave told me to do that, so I said, okay, fine. Sometime it happens, and it's good that my Indian is getting promoted on the same platform where I'm getting promoted. So in that point, I'm happy. So I thought, let's do this, yeah.
Okay, so what kind of a statement are you going to make?
There's a lot of political thing going on, like in India, between the religious things and all.
Mm-hmm.
So Kushal is my opponent, and he belongs to Hinduism, and I'm a Muslim. But we know each other, we fight and we chill out. There is nothing like that. So I want to show the people this message that my all training partners are Hindu, they are Muslim. So we all are brothers, Jew, Christian, Muslim, Hindu, we all are brothers. So I think we should not get fooled by the politics, and we should fight each other. So I think we are fighting in the cage, but outside the cage, we all are friends. So this is the main message I want to give to the audience.
I think that's a great statement that, you know, that can be spread across to the whole India and as well as the MMA India community. And considering you get to win, you get to raise your hand on Saturday night, do you plan on calling Hamza Koheji?
No plans of calling him. I'm okay to fight him again, but in the catchweight or featherweight division.
Okay. And
Before that, I would like to finish the pending thing which was going between me and the Pakistani guy.
Right.
So I think that will be a good matchup too, if I want to fight next.
And if that happens in 2020, when do you think would you be ready? Early 2020 or mid or?
That I can decide after this fight, like how is my situation. Because last time I fought, I had to take 6 months break because of the fracture in my fist. So that depends on the how the fight goes. If the fight goes well, I think I'll be ready in after 3 months again to fight.
Great. And with so many Indian fighters fighting on the Saturday night card, do you think the Indian MMA has finally got the much needed international platform with Brave? Or there's still some time for the Indian MMA to grow?
Indian MMA is still growing, I would say, but we have really good skilled fighters now, who have proved themselves on international platforms. So I think Indian MMA has reached to certain platform, and a lot of promotions around the world, they want to come and join Indian MMA, and they are giving a lot of opportunities to Indian MMA. It's a big thing now for Indian MMA fighter to have an Indian passport. So I think those who have Indian passport, I think they are having good opportunities in near future.
Great. And talking about your fighting career, how did you get started in MMA?
I was a rough guy with a normal like not so tough looking face.
Mm.
But I was very much interested in actions and all, action movies and all, since my childhood. Like if I remember my time, I used to jump here and there. So when I grew up in my family, I was not allowed to do martial arts because they feared that I might go and do some fights somewhere, because I used to do a lot of street fights, saving people from getting bullied and all. So I thought that I'm good in this. I started with Muay Thai. I chose Muay Thai because I wanted to use all my parts, limbs, not just boxing. I love boxing. Any martial art is good, but for me, they have the personal choice, so they choose a personal style according to them. So I chose Muay Thai because it allows me to use all my limbs, like elbow, knees, punches, kicks, etc. But then after 3-4 years of practicing Muay Thai, then I saw MMA getting like in limelight in India, and something new for me that after this, there is the next level also, like on the ground also, you have to learn something new. So I really got interested in that. I started learning, I started reading about it, and then I got into MMA. That's how.
And we all know that as an MMA fighter, you spend a lot of time, you know, having a clean diet, maintaining a good dedication and all. But apart from a good gym, a good coach and a fight camp, what are the other important elements that the Indian MMA fighter needs today to succeed and get to the international level?
It was always my aim to educate Indian fighters to choose between right and wrong, because I have come a long way now. There was no one to guide me. So I'm always there to give suggestions if anybody is required, that what is right or what is wrong for them. Before, there were a lot of contractual issues were happening, which fighters get bonded in the contracts and they get stuck and then their life get ruined. So I need them to get educated in this thing also. If you're signing any contract, now recently we had a fight, some fighters were stuck with one promotion's contract. It was around 3 to 5 years contract, so no need to signing this long contract. And if they are not giving you opportunities, you are still stuck, and then you cannot fight in any other promotion. Apart from this, I want my amateur fighters and upcoming young fighters to concentrate on their studies also, so that they don't require any help and they read the contract, they understand well, they can talk well, they can express themselves well in the international platform. So a lot of fighters, they don't study and they like want to fight. So I think study is the primary thing. You have to just dedicate your 2-3 hours of training, and rest of the hours you have to go to your college, study, complete your graduation education, so that you are well educated, and then you don't require any help. you can help yourself then by there. And I thank my parents, especially my mom too. I was not so good in studies, but she focused on my studies a lot, and now today I'm here expressing myself in front of the whole world, you know.
And talking about your family, we all know that Munir is your brother.
Mm-hmm.
So can you throw some light on what is Munir doing these days? And do you guys even spar regularly? Does he help you in preparing your fights?
Not much now, actually. We are not in much training context right now, but we are in context regarding conducting some events and all. So we had an event in IHFF Mumbai now, where we have conducted. We have got some super talents in amateur MMA, and then we did some semi-pro body force championship, where we had around eight bouts. We got some super talents even there. So we are planning to help them. So now Munir has taken the fighters to world championship in Singapore. So right now he's in Singapore.
Okay.
With the fighters, so he couldn't join me now. He couldn't join me for the training as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm doing my own training with my different team. Yeah, that's it.
So one last question. What can we expect from Farhad in 2020?
I had a big vision actually in near 5 years. So I think 2020 will be great. I had a great 2019. Even after I have not fought, but I have felt it was great for me. So I think 2020 will be super awesome. I think something new might come up. You know, you don't know what is going to happen. You don't know the future, but you have that positive vision regarding that.
Okay.
So I think something's better than this going to happen.
Thank you so much, Farhad, and wish you all the best for your fight tomorrow night.
Thank you, man.
So much.
Thank you so much. Yeah.